It's day 20. Had a long one last. I think we went halfway into the Star Wars movie on last yesterday's answer. So we'll see how long this one goes on. It comes from Derek Compare, D_Compare on the Twitters. He's a great fellow, by the way. The question is this: if it came to it, and we're pretty close these days, which would you prefer for the long-term stability of Doctor Who? Annual seasons of 5 to 6 episodes or biennial seasons of 10 to 12 episodes? Yeah.
Biennial, because I'm used to it by now.
Kind of are. We're kind of used to like sort of really long gaps in between Doctor Who seasons, aren't we?
Mm-hmm. You know? Like, it's just kind of a thing now. So it's, do I love it? No. Is it a thing that's happening? Sure. Yeah.
Because we had the gap from one Christmas special to another in Capaldi's era, and then resolution to Spyfall.
Yeah,
that was a year,
whole year, one metric year.
It's not the default, but because there are so many other British shows that do 6 episodes, that's their year. That's it. So whatever, IT Crowd or Dairy Girls or whatever, that's just what they do, and they do their 6, maybe a holiday special, and then next year is the next series. I think I'd rather have annual, like, 6-episode series rather than every second year with more.
Really?
I'd say every second year, A, because I'm used to it, but also B, because you may have noticed there's a hell of a lot of TV out there. So it's not like in years gone by when this is the only show I would watch or have the option to watch rather than complete garbage. Now there's a ton of good stuff out there and some middling stuff. And so, yeah, you notice it's gone, but do you notice it as much? Probably not.
How do people who binge watch things, I don't count myself among their number, like, they wait like a year and a bit for like the new season of Stranger Things, and then it comes back, and then like, and they think, oh my God, it's back, let's watch all of it now, and they watch it, and like, they've waited a year and a half, and one day, and then that day is over, and this is, well, we watched it, and now we wait another year and a half. I don't think
watch it again in between.
Yeah, but also, I don't think binge-watching is a rewarding experience if you do it all in one go. Having done it myself with The Expanse for season 3, more or less, I watched, I think, 6 episodes one day and then 6 the next. And I didn't feel good about it afterwards. And I'm watching them for a podcast now, 2 at a time, and it's a much better experience. I'm currently quasi-binging Watchmen because I'm trying to catch up before the next episode, so I've gone through 3 or 4 of them. But that's a little different, and it's still ongoing, and it's a weekly show. So
and there's only
I think
6 or 7.
There's a happy medium in there, is what I'm saying.
Yeah, I remember once upon a time buying one of the Futurama DVD volumes, and I sat there and binged between the proper episode and the episode with commentary. I watched 23 Futurama episodes in one day.
Oh my God!
And
what?
when all was said and done, I'm like, that's too much.
That is too much.
Yes. Now, I have done that with a few half-hour shows where I think I watched all 10 of Toasted London in one day or 2 days because they just go by so fast. But I couldn't do it with hour-long shows. There's just no way.
No.
Well, as we record this, by the time this goes out, we'll be done. But we're 3 or 4 episodes away from finishing season 3 of The Crown.
Uh-huh.
And that's in a watching, because we hadn't watched The Crown at all. So when season 3 came out, we went back to the start of season 1 and just watched it all. So it was 30 episodes total. And for the 26 or 7 we've gone through, that's been just about 3 weeks.
Right.
So on average, what's that, 1.5 episodes a day?
Gross.
Like that's
too much. That's fine.
That's an okay pace.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's more than okay. I'd say 2 episodes is fine, 2 a day.
Do you remember them though?
And
do you remember
that's a full hour as well. It's not 42 minutes.
Can you look back and go, oh, what was your favorite episode of The Crown? Oh, it was episode 3 of season 2. No, it's just
I can do that. No. I watched Breaking Bad that way. I watched 2 episodes a night for about a month or so, and it was fine. I did actually sink in that way.
If I sat down with something like an episode guide or reference material or something, I could go back and say, yeah, I did like that one. I didn't like that one. This is what I liked about the other one. But I could not do that from memory because...
No.
I couldn't do it week to week either, honestly.
No, I couldn't.
I could do it with Doctor Who and Star Trek because I've seen them all a billion times each.
Yeah, but they totally blend together.
the great thing about Doctor Who is that, you know, it's many people have said this, it's like an anthology show. It doesn't, you know, The Crown, okay, well, hey, it's another episode set in Buckingham Palace. How about that? Whereas Doctor Who, it's like, hey, let's go from a futuristic space planet in 1 week, and then let's go back to 1955 in Birmingham, Alabama the next. So you remember the changes. So,
well, there's, yeah. I mean, The Crown might be.
To be fair, not everybody wants to watch Doctor Who. Some people dig The Crown. And so for them, whatever's in The Crown, is even if it is set in Buckingham Palace, is a bigger deal to them. So
The Crown might be a bit of an exception to that, because they do like an episode dedicated to the moon landing and an episode dedicated to like JFK visiting.
Whoa. I had no idea that the royal family went to the moon.
Yeah.
All part of this is a hoax.
Well, it's more that they came from the moon.
That makes.
Well, they are lizards after all.
Yeah. So I think I would like biennial seasons of 10 to 12, because when you look at it, it's 10 to 12 weeks, which is 3 months, which is fine. Especially, let's face it, when you're planning a podcast, that's 3 months of content right there. And to do one season a year of 5 to 6 episodes, like what do we do for the rest of that time?
Well, that's just it, though. I mean, so let's say you have this run of let's go 12. Let's go back to Capaldi's era.
Yeah, why not?
You got this run of 12 in a 2 year span. If there aren't any holiday specials, or even let's say there are, so we had 2 more episodes in there. It's 14.
Right. Yeah.
So you got 104 week span. 14 weeks are covered. You got 90 weeks. Pretty much straight. That's where you don't have the new stuff to talk about. Yeah. Whereas if you have the annual ones. It's only half a dozen or whatever, maybe a holiday special, but then it's only 40 something weeks in between.
Yeah, but I need Adric to help me on this math.